Now, as we talk about series, again, arithmetic still stands with the fact that these sequence of numbers will continue to go up by that common difference. They'll continually go up by this common pattern. But a series will be a summation or sum of that entire list of numbers, a sum of that entire sequence of numbers. Now, the formula for that, you'll see S sub n stands for summation equals n divided by 2, and we'll talk about that in a second where that comes from, times the a sub 1 plus a sub n term. Again, n is still the number of terms, a sub 1 is still the first term, a sub n is still the last term in the sequence. So where this formula kind of comes from is this. Let's start with a real basic sequence. We'll say 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is our sequence. It's arithmetic. It's increasing by 1. Our common difference is 1. So if we were asked to do a summation of this, or find, you know, the series, we would add all four of these numbers together. 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4, and see that the entire series equals 10. The summation is 10. So a way to think about this is if you took the first term and the last term together, that would give me 5. Now, if I worked in and followed this pattern all the way through, like 2 and 3, that gives me another 5. I would effectively have 2 5s. And looking at the formula, 4 divided by 2, again, 4 terms here, that's where I would get 2. When I summation those terms, again, I would get 5. So it tells me there would be 2 5s in this entire series. Now, you might say, like, well, okay, well, what happens? What happens if perhaps we did not have an even number of terms? What happens if maybe we have an odd? All right, well, let's put 5 in. Let's see if our pattern still works. Okay. So if we put 1 and 5 together, we'd get 6. 2 and 4, we would get 6. But then there's a 3 in the middle. So our summations every time are giving us 6, 6, but this leftover 3, that doesn't really work. But notice the formula, n over 2, 5 over 2 would be 2.5. I would have 2.5 sixes. Half a 6 is 3. So where the formula comes from based with the numbers, again, everything still has to work. Now, we will not do that most of the time. Most of the time, we'll just utilize a formula, utilize the series, the summation formula, and find that sum for the amount of terms that they have given us. So for example, in this sequence, starting with 60, there are 50 terms. There are 50 terms. We could, again, knowing the last term, find the common difference and then add them all up one by one by one by one, and that would take a very long time. So instead, we are going to find the summation of all 50 terms. So to find the sum of all 50 terms, again, we already know there are 50 terms. We know the first term is 60, plus we know the last term is negative 136. So again, if somebody asks me, all right, there are 50 numbers in this sequence. I know the first one is 60. I know the last one is negative 136. In between, there are 48 more numbers. What is going to happen if you took all 48, or I'm sorry, all 50 of those numbers and added them? You would get negative 1,900. Let's clean that up a little bit. So, utilizing this idea and this formula might require us to use our sequence formula from previous lessons. So for example, the summation formula uses the number of terms, the first term, and the last term. So this next example, we know the first term, we know there are 8 terms, and we know this common difference. So theoretically, we could write all 8 terms by adding 6 every time. So 42, and then 48, and 54, and so on and so forth. And then add all of those 8 terms together to find the series, to find the summation. However, if there were 80 terms, this would become rather time consuming. So what we're going to do, we are going to use our sequence formula, which again says a sub n, and in this case our a sub n is actually our eighth term. That would be our last term in the sequence because there are only eight terms. So I take my first term plus my difference, again knowing that there are only eight terms. So I have my a sub 1 plus d times n minus 1. Now again, we need to make sure we follow our order of operations correctly. And what we're going to see is that the eighth term here, the last term in this particular sequence, is 84. That's the a sub n. That's the eighth term. That's the last term in the sequence. So now we can use our summation formula to find out what the sum of the eight terms would be. There are eight terms, so n over 2, times the first term we already knew, plus our a sub n, our last term, which we just figured out, was 84. So if we take all eight of these terms and add them all together, the sum of all eight terms would be 504. So we don't actually need to find the other six numbers in between to know what would happen if I added all them up. Could we? Yes, we could, but it did not ask that of us. Now, in going through this last one of finding it, we're going to have to do similar process. We know the first term is 16. We know the last term is 112. What we don't know, technically, is the number of terms, so we cannot use our summation formula. So whenever this happens, we have to fall back on our arithmetic sequence formula. Again, how would I know this one is arithmetic? Follow the pattern. It goes up by 6, up by 6, and this pattern is going to continue. So my common difference, my D, is 6. So what do we know? We know what a sub n is. We know the last term is 112. We just don't know how many terms there actually are. We know a sub 1 is the first term. We figured out the difference was 6. What we don't know is the number of terms. So this is very similar to when we had to write the generic formula in previously learned lessons. So again, now we need to do some algebra to figure out exactly how many terms are there in this particular sequence. So again, we're going to solve for n, so then we can utilize that information to tell us exactly how many terms are in this sequence. So again, by doing a little bit of algebra, what we're going to find out is there are 17 terms in this particular sequence. So now that we know there are 17 terms in the sequence, again, we could have just kept adding 6 every time and filled in all the missing numbers in the sequence. And then once we had all of them, add all 17 together to get the total summation of the series. But again, we don't want to be doing that if there's something like 170 terms. So now again, we want to go back to our summation. What is our summation again of all 17 of these terms? Well, again, now we know there are 17 terms. We knew the first term was 16. We knew the last term was 112. So again, just following order of operations here to figure out what our final summation is actually going to be. So sometimes we do have to do a little legwork with our sequence formula instead of just being able to add all the numbers together. Could we have added all the numbers together? We could have, but you know, it gets to take little more time than we might want to spend. So the summation of all 17 of these numbers will be 1,088. So what if we're asked a question based on the summation? So we know the sum of all these terms is going to be 1,767. We know the first term is 12. We know the last term is 174. What we don't know are a couple of things. We don't know the number of terms. So, yes, we know the first term is 12. We got to come up with two more terms here. Well, since it's arithmetic, we know it have a common difference. Well, what are we adding every single time? We don't know that. So we need to find D in the arithmetic sequence formula. However, in the arithmetic sequence formula, we also need to know the number of terms. So what do we have to do? We're actually going to start with our summation formula first. We know the final summation. Knowing the final summation, again, we can insert this into our summation formula. We don't know the number of terms. We do, however, know the first term and the last term. So by utilizing the summation formula, what we're going to be able to do is actually figure out how many terms are there in this particular problem. So again, first we need to add our first term and our last term together, and then divide that by 2 to get our 93n. Divide our final summation by that 93, and this will tell us there are 19 terms in this particular sequence, in this series. Now that we know there are 19 terms, we can go back to our sequence formula. So again, knowing our last term is the 174, that's our a sub n. Our first term, 12, plus our d, our common difference, times our now known number of terms is 19. So again, we're using our sequence formula. A sub n equals a sub 1 plus d times n minus 1. So what this is going to allow us to do, now that we knew the number of terms, that there were 19 total terms, it's going to allow us to now solve for this common difference. So by solving for this common difference, what it's going to give us the opportunity to do is eventually go back and figure out what would the remaining numbers be in this particular sequence. So again, as we go through some algebra to solve for this common difference, we should see that our common difference ends up being 9. Finally allowing us to understand that this sequence is increasing by 9 every single number. So going all the way back to the beginning, we knew the first number was 12, which makes the next number 21 and the third number 30, giving us the first three terms of that particular sequence. Finally, sigma notation is another way to write series. Find me the sum. In short, the easiest and quickest way to do this, utilizing your graphing calculator, is this math button, again, that we've talked about and utilized all year. When you go to math, scroll down, you'll see the summation notation. When you see that notation, the following screen will appear. You can use any variable you would like. In our example, they use k. You might as well just use the x button. Type it in as exactly as you see there. X equals 1 on the bottom of the summation, 18 on the top, 2x minus 7, and you'll get that it's 216. Where that comes from, again, is understanding there would be 18 terms. From 1 to 18, there are 18 terms. The first term, if I plugged in 1, tells me the first term is negative 5. If I plugged in 18, that would tell me that my last term in this particular sequence is 29. Now, again, this is me utilizing the formula. I would recommend you just go ahead, use the calculator, save yourself some time. Either way, you get that it's 216 for the summation.